Dear brothers, trust is very important in our everyday life. Some of the brothers with serious problems with their tooth, they often go to our doctor Samir. He talks well, it seems. And then many are satisfied with his treatment. And then for any ortho issues, we have a specialist here, Dr. Srinivasan, especially from the priest. He doesn't get any money at all. And so many people trust him. Today we heard the Lord God is an everlasting rock. We can trust him. We can trust him. What is the meaning of our trusting the Lord? What is the use of the diagnosis of the doctor and openness of the doctor to talk to us if those who go to them do not have the will to put into practice their prescription? Good doctor, you may say. But then you don't want to do what the doctor says. That means there is no meaning to your trust. I think same thing with regard to our own spiritual journey, life of faith. There must be a correspondence between our manifestation of trust when we attend the Eucharistic celebration, when we come here for morning prayer, evening prayer, and other spiritual exercises, and with our life. The Lord said today, what is the use of saying, Lord, Lord, all the time, but your life contradicts what you say by your mouth. Example is better than precept. Actions speak louder than words. We pay lip service but not life service to our proclamation of faith within the church in the holy places. Our life must manifest that we do really trust him. That's why the Lord today, at the conclusion of the Sermon on the Mount, speaks of two kinds of people, the wise people and the stupid people. Are we wise? Are we stupid? That is the question. The stupid person hears the word, proclaims the faith aloud in the community or personally, but does not do the will of God, doesn't put the word of God into practice. But the wise man listens and then sees to it that he puts into practice. It will be a tragedy if there is a conflict between our proclamation of faith and our daily life of faith. Daily life of faith. Live according to your faith. St. Paul again and again to all his people says, live your life worthy of your calling. Live your life worthy of our calling. The best example, my dear brothers, is Mother Mary. She listened to the word of God. Listening is conceiving. Our moments of prayer are conceiving. Young and old can conceive. Men and women can conceive. Moments of prayer, moments of meditation, moments of recollection are all moments of conceiving. What is giving birth? Practicing it during the day. That is giving birth. It is not enough to conceive in the chapel, but we have to give birth outside the chapel during the day, throughout our life. Otherwise, we conceive, we don't give birth. We will become moral abortionists. Today's religious and priests are moral abortionists. They conceive in the chapel, read the word of God, talk aloud about God, but then they don't give birth. But there is also the other category, which want to say all the time, work is my worship, no prayer. They are like wanting to produce babies, test tube babies without conceiving. Both are dangerous. Listening to the word of God is conceiving. Praying is conceiving. Let us give birth like the wise man, holding on to the Lord. Holding on to the Lord throughout our life. Let there not be a contradiction or conflict between our practice of faith in the church and our daily life outside the church. Amen.